Hi guys, welcome to my O365 Academy channel. My name is Akash. I'm a Microsoft certified professional and have been working with Microsoft services for the last 10 years. Today, I'm going to talk about a quite new feature by Microsoft, that is SharePoint App Bar. The SharePoint App Bar is a new menu that will appear on any SharePoint online site in Microsoft 365. The App Bar will only appear on modern sites and not classic sites. The App Bar features global navigation and personalized feeds that will help user navigate, find content and resources no matter what site they visit in SharePoint. You will have the navigation and home site quickly available in the menu. It is visible on the left-hand side of a site, like a small skinny bar. There are four tabs in the App Bar: the global navigation, sites, news, and files. I will discuss about them separately going forward. According to the Microsoft roadmap plan, the App Bar feature will be rolled out completely by the end of May 2021. You can try App Bar feature in your own personal dev tenant. In case you don't find it already, you can do a trick to get it pushed from Microsoft side manually. For this, you need to go to Office 365 Admin Center, go to Settings. Under Settings, you need to go Organization Settings. And then in the Organization Profile tab, you will find Release Preferences. In the Release Preferences, you have to select Targeted Release for Select Users. You can choose Select User and then type the name of the user you want to publish this app for. Then save it. It can take a few hours for the App Bar to appear. This trick worked for me. I personally reached out to Microsoft through a ticket because I wasn't able to get the App Bar, and according to Microsoft, it can take the complete May for my tenant to get this feature. But with this trick, I got it in a day. Now let's talk about Global Navigation tab. This is the only tab that you can customize. The other three tabs in the App Bar are not customizable, and the content on those is enabled by the Microsoft Graph. You can see the same content by adding the web path, sites, recent documents, and news on a page. On the Global Navigation tab, you can add your company logo, title, and what navigation that should be used here. Please note that if you disable the global navigation, then this icon will link to your personal SharePoint page where all sites that you follow, visited, etc. are displayed. You must set up your site as a home site to use it as a global navigation. Make sure that all users have read access to the site, otherwise they will not see the links on the global navigation tab. You can use audience targeting on the links if you want to show links only to specific people. You can enable global navigation by going to site settings and global navigation. This is a new option on the site settings menu. You must be at least site owner to do this. You should click the toggle button enable global navigation. You can add a title and a logo from here. You should make sure to use high resolution images as it is really very small and may appear blurry if not chosen correctly. According to the recommendations, logo size should be 20 x 20 pixels. The file should be PNG type and it should have transparent background. The last step is to determine what navigation that should be displayed on the home button. If your home site is a hub site, you have two options to choose between. The first one is hub or global navigation. This is the same menu as is displayed when you enable your site as a hub site. And this is the mega menu actually. Second option is home site. And this is the local menu that is displayed in the site header. If the home site is not a hub site, you can only choose to show the local home site navigation. Now let's talk about how you can add or edit links in the global navigation. On the global navigation settings panel, you have a link to edit global navigation, where you either create the new global navigation menu or edit the links. If you already are using the global navigation on your hub site, then the same links will appear. You edit the menu in the same way as you do on a hub site. Now let's see each tab individually in the App Bar. On the top, we have global navigation here, where you see all the links according to the navigation you have selected. I have selected hub site navigation for my global navigation, so that's why I see the same links as I see on my hub site. Under global navigation, you have sites or my site, where you see all the sites you frequently visited or the sites you follow. On the third position, you have news, where you see all the news which are targeted to you. The last one is my files. This tab shows all the files which you have recently visited or used or modified. The new app bar is visible on all your SharePoint sites, no matter if they are connected to the hub site or not. If the site is connected to a hub site, then it inherits global navigation both at the top of the site as well as in the app bar. This means that on sites that are connected to a hub site, there will be a double global navigation, one which is the mega menu and other on the global navigation button in the app. If a site is not connected to a hub site, then it will show its own home site navigation and the app bar global navigation. You can also change how the global navigation is displayed on the site by going to the settings of your hub site and click on change the look and header. I'm using the extended layout, which makes the mega menu appear below the site header. It is more visible there, I think, than above the header. Lastly, we can discuss about how you can disable the app bar. The app bar will be enabled by default, so you don't have to do anything to make it visible. But something to think about is if your SharePoint site has its own customizations like branding, or if you use the placeholder for displaying messages like very important message or alert or any notification, etc., then this app bar can overlay those customizations. Then in that case, you can disable the app bar, but please remember that this will only be possible until the end of October this year. You will not be able to keep it disabled forever. To disable the app bar, you have to use partial command set PNP temporarily disabled app bar true. You can also check the status of the app bar by the command get PNP temporarily disabled app bar. Now in the end, I would like to talk about my thoughts on the app bar from design perspective. The good things with the app bar is that the navigation is always present in the left hand side so that you can easily reach out other sites or links and your own personal content. The bad thing with the app bar is that there will be double up menus if your home site is a hub site and you have the mega menu enabled. Then you have the same menus both at the top of your site and on the left side. The combination where a site is not associated to your hub site looks better, where you only show the local home site navigation and then you find the global navigation links in the app bar. One of the ugly parts is that the app bar looks boring and with its gray design and faded icons, and it doesn't fit in on the rest of the beautiful intranet site that you might have set up. It should at least follow the color theme of the site or be customizable so that you can add your own colors or icons according to your internet theme. According to Microsoft, this is the upcoming feature. That is all what I wanted to share about App Bar. But hey, do you know about VIVA connections in Teams? At Microsoft Ignite last year, the home site button for Microsoft Teams was announced. This button has now been integrated into VIVA connection instead, but it looks slightly different as there will be tabs for the resources and the dashboard, etc. I'm preparing another tutorial where I'm going to talk about how you can set up VIVA connections in Teams. Until then, stay tuned. I hope you liked it and it helped you to learn something new today. You can also let me know in comments if you have any doubts. I'll for sure answer it as per my best knowledge. Once again, if you found this video helpful, give it a like, and if you want to keep up with all latest quick tip videos that I'll keep releasing, subscribe to my channel. So we'll meet again in my next video. Until then, take care and goodbye.